Hi, you guys. How are you all doing? I hope you're having a fantastic day. I am cooking today because I'm hungry. I'm hungry right now. I wish it was done, but you know what? I'm going to attempt pink vodka sauce with penne pasta. I've been hearing so much about it, and I thought, you know what? I'm going to make my own. Yes, you can cheat, you guys, and do the already bottled spaghetti sauce and stick in the cream, but I'm gonna try it homemade. Okay, we're gonna try. Of course, you know, like what's in our hand? Oh well, you know, it's that wine opening time. Cause I'm just gonna try and get in the spirit of it, and we're going to have some Chianti. I love the little holder it comes in. I will save it. I guess a lot of people put like candles in those later, but yeah, I want to cook and have wine, so I'm going to open this first. Yeah, okay, so let me do that. I'm so excited. I usually have my pink bottle opener, but don't know where that is. And usually, when I get my Asti, I don't know if it got dark, you guys. Oh, you know what? When I go back, it gets a little darker. So I'll go. Usually have the twist offs for my Asti. So I'll try to do as much as I can closer to you guys. I think I can. Maybe this is a good authentic wine. So I don't even. This is De Aquino. Aquino Chianti. Okay. I like to think, oh yes, it's imported from Italy. No, it's not. It's imported from Trader Joe's to my door. So, oh, hopefully it's not too. Wow, that's in there, you guys. We did it. I did it. Okay, you and me did it. I know you guys were cheering for me out there, but ooh, nice, nice, nice. Now, when we serve wine, if you're like going to a very nice restaurant, you would not serve the wine cork like this. It would be like, no, that's why you wear the white gloves so you don't get your own hand oils on the cork. Or if you had any, lotion or perfumes. Me, I can do it. But that's why they wear white gloves to serve the wine in, so. Okay. What is this from? Salute. I don't know what that one is. Doesn't matter. Let's get our wine glasses. One of my favorite wine glasses, as you know, because it's slanted. I love that. Pier one. Pier one. Okay, you guys. And then you're supposed to, aromatically. And we're getting right into it, though. This is not wine tasting 101, so. There we have it. I hate it though when you get wine out and it's like down there you can hardly see it, but I at least like to put it halfway between the half, like a fourth. But I know like a 4 ounce pour, or somebody even had a 3 ounce pour. I'm like, seriously? Anyway, cheers. Cheers to our pink vodka sauce, you guys. Very nice. Very nice. Okay, I gotta put you aside. Come on over here, Marilyn. Marilyn is part of my. Vodka making sauce. First, you guys, I've got my pan of water over here. I'm gonna start boiling. Also, I'm gonna put a little some salt in it. Find my salt. Put it up there. There we go. Well, okay. I have got a full. I got some full right up there. Should I have gone through it and got rid of stuff that was already expired? So did that. We're good. Now, this, since we're doing it fresh, it doesn't add oregano or any of that stuff, you guys. So, like, okay. Put this right in front of you that you can't see. So, yeah, let's get started. We've got our water going for our pasta. Oh, yeah, I'll need a can opener for the crushed tomatoes. Now, I'm not going to measure, but this is kind of how it's going to go down. Medium onion, yellow or white. And three garlic cloves. More if you're into garlic. I'm into garlic. And we're going to also need a grater because we're going to grate them, which I have never done because I'm so afraid I'm going to take the skin off my fingers. But you know what? I'm going to try because that's what it calls for. Right? And fresh basil. However you see fit. 1 cup of cream. Didn't have cream. Trader Joe's did not have the cream when I went. So I'm going to use half and half. I'm still going to make it, but yeah. They had it, but it was out. And they even looked in the back. It was out. I'm like, it's Easter weekend, you guys. You might see this after Easter, but it is Easter weekend. So I imagine everybody must have bought it for whatever they're making. I don't know. But anyway, you guys, welcome into my kitchen again. I know it's tiny, and I appreciate you kind of squeezing in here with me. That's pretty cool. Pretty cool. So, I'm just going to open, yes, a cup of vodka. Cup of vodka. Your choice of any kind of vodka you want. Make sure it's the kind you like, though, because you are going to taste a little of the vodka. One thing, too, about this vodka sauce, and I know people go, oh, the alcohol, it all burns off. No. I'm here to tell you that all of the alcohol does not burn off. Most of it, yes, and you probably got about 5% of the alcohol left. And if you, I guess, I've heard, too, if you cook it longer, it more will go away. But, yes, it does not go away completely. That is a myth when they say, no, no alcohol. It is a myth. There it will be a little bit, a minute one. So be careful if this is like a more of a grown-up sauce. If you, especially, you know, if you want to make it for your significant other, partner, friend, or even enemy. Let me open this because, you know, I struggle. Because if I can't open this, I might as well just end the video, right? Okay. I'm going to go backwards with that. It's like I think this is a left-handed can opener. But yeah, you can use, I'm using crushed tomatoes. It's a 20-ounce can. You can use diced, but cut them up or food process them. You want this to be, I want it to be a creamy sauce. So, got something on my tongue. So I'm going to use crushed and we'll see how it goes. So I'm going to set that aside. Let me put that over here. And my water's going. I could put my pasta in because you never know. Well, I'm going to get my sauce going. Now, the first thing we're going to do is cut up our onion. Olive oil. Don't have the olive oil. Let's see if it's up in my trusty little handy dandy. Almost out of that. Gonna have to get more. You can't see, somebody got a little, couple notes up there. But, yeah, we're going to, let me get my onions out. Oh, this has been, well, this was Trisha's. And I'm like, oh, we can't ever get rid of it. So, I'm like, I dug it out. It wasn't my pantry. And I'm like, I'm going to use this. Oh, here, Marilyn. Say hey. Say hey, Marilyn. So, I'm going to use it as my... holding my onions and garlic, you guys. But you didn't know that. It's actually probably a cookie jar, but. Okay. My penne is going, so I'm gonna, and my water's going, the penne is not going yet, but put as what you want as a serving. I'm just, don't wanna make too much, but. Oh, it's all over. Okay, that looks pretty good, you guys. All right. Kind of just to have a serving or two. You know what? Got to cut down. You know what I'm saying? All right. Let's try the yellow knife today. And I'm going to show you what I learned off of cutting an onion. Okay. She cut off this end. And then she peeled off, you know, the skin part, the dry stuff. Now she only cut one end, okay? We'll see if this is easier. I think it's going to take longer, but. Okay. Whoa, pasta is going. Okay, so I cut one end off and I'm leaving the other one on. Why, you say? Well, let me show you. Right after I stir my pasta. Okay, let's. I know. And bring that to al dente. I don't even know what. I don't get the al dente. I just eat it. It all tastes the same to me. And this is why you have a glass of wine. You cook a little, you eat a little. Whatever. I'm not eating today an appetizer because I want to eat more of the pasta. Okay, so now let's chop our thing up. I'm going to get this warmed up. About 2 tablespoons. Get that a little going there. So we're going to chop our onion. And, yeah, we're going to put it in. Okay, now here's the trick to this. Watch. You're going to just go up. Let me just show you. You're going to go up to the top and cut down. Like that, and leave that intact, and that'll keep your whole onion together. So, I don't know. If I didn't have that arm, here. Oh, can't. It's not gonna work. But here, you go. We're gonna slice it. We're gonna go around. I don't even know. Well, so far I guess it's working, but you gotta get in there. But I see what she's saying. It's holding it together. Okay, so you can make a bloomin' onion out of this. Just pull it apart. That's a good thing to make next. But see how they held that together? So when you're going to now do the finer pieces, you don't have that mess of trying to get it together and everything. That's a pretty cool little trick. I like that. That is why you should watch Food Network. You never know. Keep going. Getting them close to my fingers. Gotta get all the onion. I don't want to waste the onion. I love onions. And then just kind of, yeah. And see how they held that together and it's all ready to go in there? Perfect. Perfect. And adding the onion in there at this time as I get more of it on the stove. Okay. You know, I can honestly say I have never cooked with alcohol, so I'm a little excited about how the taste is. Won't take long for that penne to be really, really good. Oh, you know what? I need a thumbnail. I don't know what I'm going to do for my thumbnail, but I do let my Keanu thing going on, so it's like, look like a wino. Yes, this could be yours too. Okay. Thanks for supporting me on that thumbnail, you guys. Whoa. Okay, so I'm going to get that going. I'm going to use the same as the water I'm using for my pasta because it's just water. So I'm going to have that slowly go. Okay, so we got to do our garlic next. Although we want our butter, we're going to melt some butter in there, like 2 pats of butter. Let me get that in there too with my onions. Actually, it says to put it in before the onions, but you know, whatever. That would be my pat of butter, and it calls for two. So that's one. Living on the edge, not measuring. Live on the edge with me, won't you please? Okay. So, that's exciting right there. The butter. You can use margarine. It don't matter. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Just trying to make sure my videos are a little lighter, and I didn't. Couldn't find my camera yet. Been looking for it. Okay, onward we go. It also, if you want chili flakes, I don't know if I do. And I don't know. I'd have to dig for them. I'm not a chili flake kind of person, but it does call for them if you want. We're going to leave them out. Okay, so. Yeah, we're going to slowly cook that olive oil, onions, and butter. So while that's going on. The penne would not be my choice of pastas, but with the vodka sauce, it's a must. It just is a must. So, you know what? Al pasta is going to cook up the same. You know, I believe that. Okay. Gosh, I feel really Italian all of a sudden. I think there were some cloves in here. So, yeah. Now we're going to grate. Our garlic, I'm a little afraid. I'm not going to lie. It's okay to face your fears. So you take off the hard, crusty stuff. I know those aren't the technical terms, but that's what I got to do. I got to take off the hard, crusty stuff. Okay, got that one. That one. There it is. They all look the same. Some are so tiny. I don't think I want a great tiny ones over there. I should probably have my littler grater, but I don't know. I feel like I would have a better hole. Now that's three. I don't know. That's probably all the more I can do. Because I'm afraid, but I do like garlic, so, I don't know how to do the garlic. But one time, somebody pounded it, or somebody pounded the bottom, but I just start it. I just take this off. They didn't teach us this in home ec class in 8th grade. I was surprised to learn that when I was in 8th grade, they taught us how to sew in home ec. They don't do that anymore. That's a lost art, too. Very sad. I remember I made a red polka dot dress, and I love that dress. So, I know this is not how you're supposed to do it, you guys, but I'm just trying to get my sauce around so I can see how it turned out. But, yeah, it's a lost art. I don't know if you guys know Michael Philpott that does all of Trisha's specialized clothing attire. He is amazing. Oh my gosh, he is so talented. And, I mean, I can sew, but that guy can just, she'll tell him what she wants and boom, it's instantly, he can do it. It's amazing through just a picture. So, he is so talented. Okay. All right, you guys, I think we're good. Let me just get rid of the rest of this off of there. I'm going to need the cutting board, though, later because we got to shred our mozzarella or Parmesan. I guess we're just doing Parmesan. I have so many recipes in my head going on. I'm like, oh, no, that's for another one. Okay. So, perfect. Now, carefully, we are going to grate our garlic. That's a penne. That's almost done. This is looking very, very good. Let me show you. That's our butter and our olive oil and our onions. And you don't want to burn them. You don't want to get them not even caramelized, just nice and warm and softened up. Okay, here we go. Oh, went black. Hello. Okay. Somebody say, should you really be drinking that before you're going to grate?
Yeah.
I'm okay. I'm going to try the little one first. Oh, so, I guess we just take it. Oh, that's not bad, you guys. Just got to be slow about it. And then it sticks. You guys see it a little bit? See? Almost ruined a fingernail. See, it's just, I don't know. Scary. Just don't go too fast, because it comes really fast to the end. I wonder if they have grating gloves. I bet they do. Oh, I'm sure they do. Hey, look, no blood. What? No blood. Okay, so I'm going to get this put in there. I will keep this. I was sure going to go down to the bottom, right, you guys? Let's see what it looks like. Oh, that's pretty good. Take it from the inside. Ooh, that smells good, though, that garlic. My mom never used garlic. I know she made lasagnas and stuff, but I guess she used like garlic powder and stuff like that. So alright, let me get the rest of that little bit in there. Now we're cooking Italian. Woohoo! Put that aside. Right there. Okay, let me wash my hands, you guys. Feeling a little garlicky. Okay, so the scary part is over. I did not cut myself. I'm gonna shut the pasta down, you guys. It looks all good. Just let it stay warm in there. And then, oh, I am so gonna do that garlic more often, you guys. It has really brought out the juices of the garlic cloves. Okay. That is simmering. Now what do we want to do? I tape everything up in my fridge. Did you guys know that? Everything's up and down, and here we go. And I got my stretch pants on to eat my pasta. Okay. Here we go. Okay, now we can salt and pepper to taste. Salt and pepper. Just put a little bit because I've already got added salt to my noodles. You know, it'll absorb some of that. I don't think I want a lot of pepper. I used to love pepper, but I'm kind of steering away from it. In fact, one time, I want to try the white pepper. I have never tried that. I don't know if that's like a more mellowy taste or what. Oh, I see some extra garlic, you guys. I don't want to waste it. I'm terrible. It's like I gotta get this off that one shred, right? Let me not do that. It'll be like that sriracha I tasted. Okay, what I want to do though, since there is no mozzarella in this recipe, I'm gonna get my Parmesan. Okay. Excuse me, pardon me. Got to go in here and get out my Parmesan. This is my welcome to my fridge. My messy fridge. But, yeah. I guess I could use this. This is probably the oldest. Stay tuned, you guys. We're coming around. We are coming around. Woo! What did I step on? I think I stepped on some an onion. One thing about a tiny kitchen is you got a tiny cleanup, right? Right. Okay, so I think we're doing good on that, and we're going to start now our salt and pepper. All right, here we go. And now, we get to add our vodka, our cup of vodka, you guys. So I'm going to move this out of the way because I don't need to grate. I don't need to grate on this one. Let me clean up the stove a little bit. I do like a nice clean workspace because it's only 1 square foot wide. Okay. So, I would have cooked up here, but it's probably where I have to eat. But right here, there it is. And so that's all the more I'm going to cook my onions. And then I'm using my Tito's. I would have used Grey Goose too. Those are my favorites. But you're going to add a cup. Or how, you know, if you want less, that's fine. Okay. Because I don't have, okay, there you go. That's your vodka. And the alcohol will start to cook off. So, let that go. You want to, I could probably, I'm not doing an advertisement for Tito, so let me just put that over there in the back. Okay, so, here we go. Lost my spoon. I have to say, though, if you guys don't have a lot of time, probably just get the spaghetti sauce. I'm going to try it both ways. Not today, but this just seems so simple. And I love the fresh of garlic and the onions and the butter. And if I have time, I will cook. Oh, there we go. And let it be daylight. Okay, so, now I'm going to, that could simmer a little bit too, but due to the time, we are moving right along. And the crushed tomatoes going next. Perfect. Messy. So, how they have ASMR, the sounds? I need something for the smells, so you can pick up the smells of it. And we're just going to stir that in. Okay. So keep it on the burner. Oh, that looks really good. Okay, so we got the crushed tomatoes in. We're going to let that bubble. Then we're going to pour in some of the basil and simmer and then do our cream. Okay? So let me get out. It's easy peasy, right? Let me get out my basil. It reminds me, I need to make some bruschetta. I have not done that for a while. So, nummy nummies. I never know whether to wash it, and I will just give it a quick rinse, but sometimes I feel like if you're doing heat, it's all gonna just, you know, go down anyway. So it just says, put in torn fresh basil. So that's what we're gonna do. I should have you guys this way. I wonder how that would work. I don't know how the shot would be, but next time we'll do it that way. I feel like I can back you up a little ways, but so we're just gonna tear this up, you guys. Get the plant out of the way. Ooh. Trisha and I go to her favorite place at the Grill where they make the pizza and the margarita pizza, I think, and they have fresh basil on top, and she doesn't like it, so I'm like, oh, take your basil. I mean, there's probably only 5 leaves on the whole small pizza, but I'm like, I will take it. You guys can put in as much as you want. I love a fresh basil. Okay. And then when you're done, you can even add more. But, okay, so. I don't even mind the big leaves at all. So, leave that to the bubbling thing. Let me put my plant there. Okay, so, you guys, I'm going to get my pasta out. penne.
One more. Can't miss out on that.
Okay, so I guess I better get a dish of some sorts. What do I want to eat off of? Well, choices, you guys. Let me go with the shells. We're going to go with a ocean theme. Trying to see how the pink sauce would show up best. Good choice, right? Good choice. Okay. So now, I'm not gonna drain my pasta. I'm just gonna use one of these little doohickeys. That's really nice. Oh, can't even see. See what I'm doing? Okay, so I'm just like shaking the water off that way because, I actually think we add this. Simmer and I guess you can add it or you can just put it on top. I don't know how to add it though. I haven't had pasta for a long time. I was thinking, I should have something more meaty, more protein-ish, but it's like just gotta treat myself, and so that's why I'm like, oh yeah, I'm gonna make this sauce. It's like that looks so good. So that's our penne. At the end also it says to add another tablespoon of butter. I don't get that. I'm not gonna do it. If you want to, you can. Don't get that part. I don't know what it would do extra. I guess just make it extra rich. Okay, you guys, now this is starting to bubble, so I'm gonna add the cream that isn't the cream, but it's okay. Turn it down to simmer. So here we go. This is what's gonna give it its pinkness. I would add about a cup. Let's see how it looks. Oh yeah, beautiful. There it is. There's your pink sauce, you guys. Just keep mixing it together. Lovely. Lovely, lovely. Okay. Since you guys know I got my butter out, I am going to add another pat. Since that's what it says, we'll do it. Wow, this is going to feed me for a week. Well, people come and visit me. Okay, so now let that melt. Okay, let me keep draining this a minute because it's going to take all the noodles that I did make. Whew. And there they go, all over the floor. Woo! Okay, let me get the last of them out. So they can suck all that great sauce that we're making up. I'm just going to put some in there now. I was watching Rachel Ray, right? You guys, I've been talking about her 30-minute meal show, but I was watching it. I taped it because she had something really good that I wanted to make. And I watched it all the way through because usually I'll fast forward to the commercials. But I noticed that they stay on her during the commercials. How is it that I saw that? Because they would have to run the commercials. But I don't know. Maybe this was a special segment. But, sorry. Just don't feel that. Anyway, they has kept on taping it during the commercials. Maybe they went to the commercials and then they showed that they were still, they taped the behind the scenes, and that's just weird. She's like, oh, I don't got anything to do, I'll just wait. And the crew's just like hanging out, and she's like, just hanging, you know? And she's like, okay. She goes, I'm going to do this and this when the camera's rolling. I'm like, now it's become a YouTube, because now you're doing everything behind the scenes, although I know they probably do edit. But, yeah, that was a little strange. I don't know. And then they're like, okay, and 3, 2, 1, and she's, hey, everybody, how you doing? I don't know. I didn't get that part. I don't know if they do that with every show, but it's like, okay. So, oh, you guys, this looks so, so good. Can you see it? Oh, I should just bring, let me bring my computer over. I had it plugged in, but I just get it on top. Wow, you guys, that is, why can't I just get it? Here we go. That is your penne sauce. That is a zoom in that the cameraman would do. There we go. There we go. I don't know why. There we go. I gotta stay that way. Okay, so I'm gonna put the pasta in now. And then we can eat, you guys. I am so excited. I'm just gonna push this over here. I know you're like, oh, she's using her fingers. Here, I got another story of that. I was watching the kitchen. I tape that sometimes just to see those people. I don't know. Anyway, Sunny was making, I forget what she was making. It was just on. And everything she did, she, you know how they measure out all the ingredients and those little bowls? She always would take her fingers and then she used her fingers on everything. Okay, slide this, do that. I'm like, people would taste that. It was like she never used a utensil. Now, I'm sorry, but that's a little odd, I think, especially when you're going to feed 3 other people. And I didn't see you wash your hands, so I don't know, you guys. That's just weird. I mean, you should be a little more professional, I would think, on TV. And you guys know how, you know, I've always said that they all seem over the top. Guy's name, Jeffrey was always the cool and serene one, and I liked his demeanor. I thought, wow, you know, you got a little class about you. On that same episode, you guys, here's Jeffrey is being loud and boisterous and I'm like, that is so not him. What is wrong? I'm sorry. it's just me, but it's like, Jeffrey, that's not who you are. You're trying to be, you know, like everybody else, you know, with their big mouths and stuff, but it's just kind of got out of control. I'm like, wow, that was sad. But I thought I had to take a step back. In fact, I had to rewind that, and I'm like, is that really Jeffrey? Oh my gosh. But anyway, I don't know if I'm gonna have enough wine with my pasta, so let me just get a little bit more. I'm going to need a little bit to clean up the dishes anyway, you guys, right? Right. Okay. Well, I think it's time we can dig in. And I guess we'll just, I know you should probably cook this a little longer, but I'm just so excited. I feel like I need a big spoon to dip it in, but I don't know what to do. I don't even know how they serve it. Oh, I suppose with tongs. I know the spaghetti part of it, but that ain't gonna work. But here we go. I know this isn't the right technique, you guys, but it at least gets it on my plate. I want to get all that oregano. I need to add a scooper. What I need. Ooh, messy. Gonna have to clean up the stove. That's okay. Oh, this looks amazing. How's that, you guys? Okay. That looks good. I think I do just want a little more of sauce. So I'm going to just dig it, have it come out with this. Oh. Now, if you don't like those chunky, even though they're crushed tomatoes, you could use a puree. Okay, you guys, look at that. Oh, my gosh. And I'm going to put Parmesan on mine. I love me some Parmesan.